Hi, I'm Mike Havey. I'm a Senior Specialist Solutions Architect with AWS. In today's Neptune Snackables, I want to investigate how you can discover or reverse engineer the model or the schema in your Neptune graph database. And once you've discovered it, how you can draw it using diagram as code tools. Now, if you're reverse engineering, it means you've already adopted graph. What was the promise of graph that motivated you? We know that graph is built from some basic building blocks. We have nodes and edges. Nodes represent business objects. Edges represent their relationships. And from those foundations, we can tackle some technical challenges. We can combine data across different silos. We can find connections or between objects. We can work with heterogeneous data. And our data can be full of many-to-many relationships. And therefore, we can build use cases such as social networking, recommendations, knowledge graphs, fraud detection, life sciences, network and IT use cases, all of which involve highly connected data domain, the ability to query that highly connected structure, and indeed to filter results based on strength of relationship. So Amazon Neptune is a managed graph database service from AWS that implements graph. And among its attributes are that it is open, supporting both Apache TinkerPop labeled property graph representations, as well as Resource Description Framework, or RDF, from the W3C. It can scale to achieve fast performance with the ability to query billions of relationships with millisecond latency. Its architecture lends itself to a great deal of reliability, durability, and fault tolerance. And it is flexible in supporting the three main query languages today, Gremlin, OpenCypher, and Sparkle. Now, we already started. Now we want to know what's in our database today. So we probably started our graph journey with some sort of data model, some sort of graph model. And naturally, our intention is that the model, that the data that lands in our database follows that model. But if you've been doing graph for some time and are well into your life cycle, who knows? You probably want to take some sort of inventory and to see what the data actually looks like. So you may have development databases that have been around for many sprints, have had many contributors and lots of exploratory activities. So who knows what's actually in your dev database today? A test database is a bit more controlled, but probably has many versions of data. You want to take inventory there too. And even production, which is highly controlled, may have some surprises. So let's check it out. What I'd like to demo is a tool that discovers and then visualizes the model that's actually in your database. And once you've seen that visualization, you can compare it to what you started with and to see how close they are. So what we want to do is to take an inventory of the types of things, the types of nodes and edges, rather than the individual instances that are in your graph. And we want to be able to draw it using a clear, uncluttered picture, and it should scale. Even if the database is huge, we should be able to produce this visualization of the schema quickly and efficiently. Now, working in our favor here is the fact that databases tend to have lots of instances, but the number of types tends to be much smaller in number. And but nonetheless, if part of our discovery means looking at instances to find patterns that would allow us to generalize types, that also needs to scale. So even if it's a huge database, we need to be able to do that efficiently. Okay, let's look at the tool in action. In my AWS account, I've created two resources that I'll need. One is a Neptune database cluster, which I'm showing here. And I also created a notebook. So this is a SageMaker notebook instance, And I'm actually going to be using the notebook to drive the discovery and visualization of the data in the Neptune database cluster. The discovery tool is available in GitHub. So here's the code. And what I need to do is move this over to my notebook instance. So I have it here. You can see that it's in a folder in Jupyter. And I have two notebooks, one to demonstrate labeled property graph, the other to demonstrate RDF. I'll talk about labeled property graph. So I'll open up this notebook. I already have it open. And let's walk through it step by step. So the first step will be to install the iPlantUML plugin. As I said, I'm going to use plantuml to render the diagram. And then I'll import the iPlantuml library so that I can call it later to render the diagram. And then I'll do some setup by configuring a connection to my Neptune cluster, its host, port, and other details. And it will be against that database that I do my discovery. Now I'll seed some test data. I'm actually starting with an empty database cluster. In your case, there may be existing data in your cluster. So I'll load three different data sets, airports, fraud graph, and knowledge graph. And I'm going to use the seed magic, which ingests this data into my Neptune cluster from a set of test files. So this is useful data. What I want to do is have the discovery tool show me what the schema of these data sets looks like. And I'm going to poke around a bit and explore the data that I have just for fun. So in the air routes data set, what I want to look at is the connectivity from the Atlanta airport. So I'm going to run an OpenCypher query, and I'll start with the Atlanta airport and look at routes that that airport has to other airports. And I can see from the results, first of all, what airports look like. So airports like Atlanta have a description, a longitude, number of runways, and so on. So we get a sense of some of the properties of an airport. I can see that the route, which is an edge, actually has a property called dist or distance. So it's the distance of the route. And of course, since this is a relationship between two airports, on the other end of this route, we have another airport, which is Austin. And we can see that Austin has a similar set of attributes to Atlanta. Now that query was just exploration. We haven't started the discovery yet. We will start that now by getting a summary of the data in the Neptune database. So we run the summary magic, and this calls the Neptune summary API, which returns statistics that it's collected. And here's a dump of what it consists of. So it tells us about particular node labels that exist in the graph. Also edge labels, as well as some additional information like the node properties that are found, edge properties, as well as node structures, combinations of properties that we might see on nodes, and so on. This is all very useful information. We can get it very quickly because it comes directly from the statistics on the database. Next, we call our discovery tool to take that summary and do some further queries of the database. Implicitly, it uses OpenCypher queries to introspect the database. The result is held in a dictionary called observation, which basically provides a set of node types or classes, node properties, relationships, attributes of those relationships. It provides it as a dictionary that I could actually use in its own right. But what I intend to do with it is actually to draw it. So what I'll do is I'll actually call the discovery tool to render this data structure as plantuml markup text. And we can see that the result, which I have here, is a plantuml representation of my data. Since it's a UML class diagram, it consists of a set of classes. And each class can have attributes shown as the bullets. The name of the class is the node label. So you can see that there's several classes representing nodes. We also have relationships. Here are the relationships. And you can see that these will represent associations in the UML class diagram. They have names like date of birth. They connect one class to another. So in this case, date of birth connects an account to a feature of an account. And I can now paste this text into any plantuml tool, of which there are many. But because plantuml has a plugin to notebooks, I'll just draw it directly in the notebook. So next, I'll render the plantuml using the plantuml magic. And it's shown here. It's a sprawling diagram with many boxes and arrows. The boxes are classes. And as you can see, they represent nodes. There are many of them. The arrows represent edges. And because we have so many different types of data in the database, there's quite a lot to look at here. But that's fine. We wanted to discover everything. But we might want to narrow it down. So to do so, we'll regenerate the plantuml with a class filter. We want to see only four classes: continent, country, airport, version. We end up with the following plantuml markup, containing only those four classes and the relationships. And when we render it, we'll see a simplified picture. We can see the picture here in the notebook. We can also save it to a file. In the command, we're saving it to lpg_airport. If we look in the folder view of Jupyter, we can see that we have an lpg_airport.svg file. This is an image that we can share with others so that they can view it offline. All right, let's summarize. So I demonstrated a tool that takes inventory of the model that's already in your Neptune database. And why would you use such a tool? It's because that the inventory that it takes confirms that the data in your database aligns with your intended model. And it also reveals surprises. There may be types of data that you didn't expect to be in your database. And we showed that we're able to discover this data using a combination of the Neptune Summary API as well as some additional queries of the data. And that we drew it as a UML class diagram using plantuml, a diagram as code tool. And that just proves to be a really effective visualization of graph data. Some additional resources. This tool is available on GitHub at the first link. And I wanted to point out a couple of other tools that also do schema discovery. The Neptune GraphQL utility at the second link includes schema discovery. And the Neptune Graph Explorer, the third link, is primarily a visualization of instances, but it also shows the structure of the data in your database. Some related artifacts. I have a blog post on how to produce an easy model that also uses plantuml as a way of visualizing a graph model. And the notebook that accompanies that post is the second link. You can get a Neptune database cluster up and running in your AWS account within minutes at the first link shown. And also check out the Neptune Demos Hub, which includes demonstrations of various graph use cases involving Neptune. We'd love to discuss further with you. Please contact my team. Our email address is wwso-neptune-ssa@amazon.com. Appreciate your time today. Thank you very much.